All right, ladies and gentlemen. So I hope that you're able to see this clearly. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger. But what I want to do is provide a quick video or a quick overview of how to begin outlining your body paragraph for this assignment. So the first thing I want to do is just reiterate, and I'll show you right here, just confirm what the story, what the prompt is asking you to do. So it says, in the story, Two Kinds, is Jing Mei's mother justified in pushing her daughter so hard to learn the piano? You must write two arguments with specific evidence from the text to support your argument. Your argument must follow the clear format. And so the outline for paragraph one does follow the clear format. It has a space for your claim, your evidence, and your reasoning. And so what I want to do here is just plug in those pieces and sort of give you an example for you to watch before you go do this for yourself. Okay, so this is just an example. So I'm going to start with my claim. Now you can choose to use this claim or you can use a different claim, but here's what I'm going to say. Okay, in, oops, and let me go ahead and change the boldness. In the story, right, we want to give the title, Two Kinds. We'll say Jing Mei's mother is not justified in pushing her daughter so hard to learn the piano. Okay, so that's my claim, right? I'm gonna put that in yellow. You don't have to do the same, but I just wanna put that in yellow so you can see that's my position. And that's the first step. That's something that you're gonna have to do as well. Okay, you're gonna pick a side. You're either gonna say that she is justified, like she was right to push her so hard, or she wasn't right to push her so hard. Okay, so I'm saying in this example that she was not right. She was not justified to push her so hard. Okay, so now what comes next is our evidence. So I'm gonna scroll up, okay, and yesterday I told you to find some evidence that you thought you could work with. And so I wanna just highlight this one because that's what I think I'm going to use. So I'm going to copy it and I'm very, very easily going to paste it right in here. Now, I'm not going to highlight that yellow. Okay, I'm going to actually just change it to red. And I'm going to change the font to red here in a second. But what I want you to see, guys, and this is really important, is sometimes when we use evidence, some of you guys forget to put it in quotes. So if you're seeing this, you can see that I put the quote actually in quotation marks. Okay, now this is something we haven't talked about too much, but what we need here is what we call an in-text citation. We have to acknowledge that this quote came from someplace. And so we do that by putting parentheses. Tan is the author of the story's last name. So you're going to put Tan, and I'm going to go check what page this quote was on. And this quote was on page 2. So I'm going to come back down. And I'm going to put tan 2, and that's what we call an in-text citation. So far I have the claim, I have the evidence, and now I'm going to talk about the reasoning. And so this is where you explain, okay, why or how does this evidence support the theme? So let's read that evidence one more time. After seeing once again my mother's disappointed face, something inside me began to die. So let's go ahead and break down this quote and start creating our reasoning. I'm going to change the font to green just because it helps me in my mind remember what I'm doing in this part. Okay, so here we go. And now this is all coming from my brain here. This part's got to come from your brain too, right? You want to remember, okay, if I'm going to come up with some reasons, what should I say? How am I going to prove, right? This is where you're proving that this quote, in fact, helps us understand that Jing Mei's mother did push her too hard. Okay, so this line from the story shows how Jing Mei felt bad about herself when she failed the tests her mother gave her. She felt bad because she thought that she was disappointing mother. Okay, and so far we've just kind of given a quick breakdown of what's happening in this quote. We're explaining it a little bit, and now we're really going to go further into our reasoning. So I want just to kind of think, like, what is it if you disappoint your parent, right? What does that feel like? Is that a good feeling? Is it a bad feeling? And so I'm going to keep trying to reason here. I'm going to probably try to shoot for 1 to 2 more sentences in this section of my reasoning section. So I'm going to say, many times children want to make their parents proud. However, the test that Jing Mei's mother is giving her is having the opposite impact. A parent should realize when they are doing something that is not helpful to their child. Jing Mei shows how she feels really bad about herself. Okay, so now I've got some reasoning, guys. I have claim, I have evidence, and I have reasoning. And so now I want to try to wrap it all up, right? And I'm going to do that in hopefully one sentence here. I'm going to do it in one concluding sentence. So I may say something like, therefore, right? It's a nice transition word. Therefore, you're going to kind of restate what this showed you. You think about your quote, think about your reasoning. Therefore, Jing Mei's mother was so concerned with making her daughter a prodigy that she didn't or did not realize she was harming her. Pause. It is clear that Jing Mei's mother caused her daughter some pain. So, ladies and gents, if I were to take all this stuff out and really put it into a paragraph, I could literally copy each section and put that into a paragraph, and I'd have, right, I have my parts. I'd have a clear paragraph. I'd have claim, evidence, and reasoning. And so this is just an example that I wanted to show you before I sent you off to go ahead and work on your own. I'll be available for help, but hopefully this serves as a good model. Remember that you also have and a student example in this assignment that you can use to begin drafting your outline.